These seats at the session hall, originally intended for President Duterte's 5 Constitutional Commission nominees, remain vacant. As members of the Commission on Appointments Committee on Constitutional Commissions opened the panel's 3rd hearing to tackle their status. Minutes passed, but Rizalina Hustol, a nominee as chairperson of Commission on Audit, Carlo Alexi Nograles as chairman of the Civil Service Commission, and Saidamen Pangaruan, George Garcia, and Ivy Torrefranca Neri for the Commission on Elections still remained in their respective holding rooms, with only Secretary Baby Pascual of the Presidential Legislative Liaison Office meeting with them. Inside the session hall, Senator Aquilino Coco Pimentel III, who last Monday defended the president's constitutional appointees, again insisted that CA members must hear the nominees, weigh their qualifications, and confirm those who are really qualified to hold their positions. Pimentel also stressed that Constitutional Commission officers like the COA, civil service, and COMELEC appointees must maintain their independence even from incoming President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.
The appointees are independent, so who appoints them should not really be a big issue for as long as the qualification of independence, probity, integrity, competence are present in the nominee or appointee.
Pimentel's arguments was in reference to the points raised by Senate Majority Leader Juan Miguel Zubiri last Monday, that Marcos Jr. should be given the prerogative to appoint his preferred individuals who will serve the country under his administration.
We know that there is a request also from the new administration to give them that courtesy. So, as I said, it's a political body. It's a consensus. We seek the consensus of each member.
CA panel chairperson Senator Cynthia Villar then ordered for the roll call of members to determine how many of their 24 members, including the ex-official members, are present and if there is a quorum.
We had 5 members present in person and 3 members present online. The total members present is 8. The chair declares the absence of a quorum. There being no quorum, the meeting of the Committee on Constitutional Commission and Offices is hereby adjourned. Is there any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Duterte's ally, Senator Christopher Bongo, still opted to manifest his disappointment.
Madam Chairman, I just want to manifest that I would have voted in favor of this ad interim appointments kung natuloy po.
Villar clarified the circumstances of the hearing that led to the bypassing of the 5 presidential appointees.
Pwede pa silang ma-appoint.
Next administration.
It's the natural thing. Up to the last minute, kala namin may quorum. Nawala ang quorum.
In a text statement, Pimentel took a swipe at his CA colleagues for allegedly being too deferential to the incoming administration, even if they are duty-bound to deliberate on the concerns that fall under the 18th Congress. Zubiri held a closed-door meeting with the bypassed COMELEC nominees right after the hearing, but both Pangaruan and Nograles begged off from issuing statements as they exited the Senate building. Hustol immediately left after the CA hearing, while Garcia had this to say.
Lagi akong handa sa isang kaso. So pinaghahanda ako whether win or lose. Ganun din naman dito. So dapat paghandaan mo rin kung makoconfirm ka o hindi.
Incoming Communications Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles, on the other hand, says she has no information yet if Marcos will reappoint the bypassed Duterte nominees. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.